Cognitive computing has many facets. In this video, I'll show you how to use supervised learning to train, validate, and run a multi-layer perceptron network using the Neuroph Java Neural Network Framework. In this video, I'll show you how to use Neuroph to train, validate, and run a multi-layer perceptron or MLP network, and to use this network to make selections for the 2017 NCAA Division I Men's Basketball Tournament, also known as March Madness. Here's what you'll see in the video. Install the Neuroph framework, download the NCAA March Madness code from GitHub, download the regular season stats from NCAA.com, load the data into the PostgreSQL database, train and validate the MLP network, and finally, run the tournament predictor to make your selections. Let's get started. To download Neuroph, visit the Downloads page. Click on the Neuroph framework zip file, and it will be downloaded to your computer. Now expand the zip file and notice the Neuroph core jar file. The latest version of Neuroph may not be in Maven Central, so in order to do local development, I recommend you install it to your local Maven repository. Drop out to a terminal window or command prompt, navigate to the directory where the Neuroph core jar is located, and issue this command: mvn install colon install dash file dash d file equals Neuroph core 2.94.jar dash d group id equals org.neuroph dash d artifact id equals Neuroph dash d version equals 2.94 dash d packaging equals jar. This will install the jar into your local Maven repository so that it's available for your Maven builds. Next, you'll need to clone the NCAA March Madness code from GitHub. Open a terminal window or command prompt. Navigate to the directory where you want the code to land and enter this command: git clone https github.com/makotogo/developerworks. Now that you have the code on your computer, let's import it into Eclipse. Start Eclipse and choose File, Import, Maven, Existing Maven Projects. Navigate to the directory where you cloned the code. Select the project to import and click Finish. To train a neural network, you need data. I'll show you how to download the data from NCAA.com now. Go to www.ncaa.com/stats/basketball-men/D1. Scroll down the page until you see Archived National Stats and click on that link. Open the next page, select the season you want to download, then click View. Under Division, select Division 1. The 2010 tournament started on March 16, 2010, so under the reporting week, select Through Games 3-14-2010. Next to the statistical category, select Team All Statistics. Finally, click Show Report CSV. It takes a few minutes for the server to crunch the data, but when it's finished, it will download the CSV file called rankings.csv to your computer. Rename the file to include the tournament year, so in this case, I'll call it rankings-2010.csv. Repeat this process for every year you need statistical data, including the tournament year. In order for the scripts that I've provided in GitHub to work properly, I recommend you download data from 2010 through 2017. The CSV data looks like this. Each statistical category is preceded by a header indicating the category, and that is followed by the data. When the data is exhausted for a particular category, the next statistical category follows, then its data, and so on until the end of file. To load the CSV stats data into the DB, you have to do a few things. First, you have to generate SQL load scripts from the CSV data you downloaded. I provided bash shell scripts for Linux and Mac users. If you're a Windows user, you can set up a run configuration in Eclipse to drive the SQL generator program. First, navigate to the scripts directory of the NCAA March Madness source you downloaded earlier, which is under Source Main Script. Execute the run sqlgenerator.sh script and specify the full path to the CSV file you want to convert into a SQL load script. Once you run the script, it creates a single SQL file with SQL insert statements in it to load the statistical data. Next, you need to define the DB, including all the tables and views the application needs in order to do its processing. From a terminal window or command prompt, get into the PostgreSQL PSQL interactive shell as the default user, which is S. Perry in my case. Then create the NCAA BB database. Now exit the shell and connect to the NCAA BB database. From the shell, execute the build db.sql script, which will build the database from scratch. When the script finishes, the data is loaded and you're ready to train and validate the network. The first step in training and validating the network is to define the network structures you want to use. To do this, open networks.java in Eclipse. This file is where you define the structure of the networks you want to train and validate. You only specify the hidden layers here for each network you want to train. In this network, for example, the first hidden layer has 90 neurons, the second hidden layer has 30, and the third hidden layer has 20 neurons. Now build the March Madness jar file. You can do this from within Eclipse or from the command line, which is what I'll show you now. Drop out to a command line. Navigate to the root directory of the NCAA March Madness project and kick off a Maven build. Specify the clean and package phases. Now that the jar file is built, kick off the training and validation run by running the runmlptrainer.sh script and specify the years to use to train the network, followed by the years to validate, separated by commas. For the 2017 tournament, I want to train using data from 2010 through 2014 and validate using data from 2015 and 2016. So the command looks like this. /runmlptrainer.sh /2010/2011/2012/2013/2014/2015, 2016. This process can take hours or days to train your network, so be patient. And it may take several tries before you get a network that performs above the 70% threshold. Once a network performs above this threshold, it's saved to the networks directory to be used later for the tournament simulator. Okay, so you've downloaded stats data, loaded them into the database along with other supporting data from the scripts in GitHub. Then you trained and validated one or more networks. Now you're ready to run the tournament simulator. To run the tournament simulator, open a terminal window or command prompt and navigate to the scripts directory. Execute the run tournament simulator.sh script and specify the tournament year. For 2017, I'll execute this command, /run tournament simulator.sh /2017. The output lands in the data/simulations directory, just subordinate to the base directory defined in the network settings. You'll notice that there is one CSV file for each team in the tournament. Inside each file is a list of all the other teams, along with the results of a simulation using the networks you trained of that team against every other team in the tournament. When you're filling out your brackets, pick one of the teams, open its CSV file, locate their opponent, make a note of the network pick, and fill out your bracket. That's how you train, validate, and run a multi-layer perceptron neural network. I hope you enjoyed the video. I'm Steve Perry. Thanks for watching.